I want to teach you a trick that I learned from one of the fastai lessons, which will help you to understand how to open up a fastai function and see what goes inside it. Okay, to do that, let's open a Jupyter notebook, which has got all the fastbook everything installed. If you're using Jarvis platform, it should be already done for you. Yeah, okay, I was already running the notebook, so let's just open that. Okay, let's go to the first deep learning code that you will run in the first chapter, which is image classification algorithm finding dogs and cats. Okay, if you can see here, it's very amazing to see what you can achieve with a small set of lines, right? If you have been doing programming, you may get curious to understand what is happening in one of these functions. Let's say we want to understand what happens in get image files, right? One of the easiest way to understand what happens inside any particular function in JupyterLab is to add a double question mark before the function and do a shift enter. Okay, as we can see here, that gives the source code that is required for the function. Okay, so what we can do is, what I'll do now is, let me write that here so it becomes easier for me. So I can see that there are a couple of things happening. One is path, which is what we send. Okay, it's nothing but a Python path file. Okay, let's make it easier. Let's just print the path. Okay, it just shows a location of a Linux machine, and then it uses something called image extensions. So somehow fastai is importing that. What is that? Okay, it looks like it's a set. And it has got a lot of values which are common extension files for images. Okay, and then there is recurse. Basically, whatever we pass here, it's getting passed there. Folders, none. We are passing it there. Okay, so I assume that since we are passing a folder, the recurse equal to true would say that if there is a folder inside a folder, look inside if there are images, right? That's what this get files function will do. That's good, but let's try to see if we can dig deeper. Right? By tab, when you press tab in JupyterLab or Jupyter Notebook, what you get is you get all the code that is inside that function. Now, this is the actual code that happens inside get files. Okay? If you're seeing it for the first time, okay, it's often common to get confused or get scared about what is happening. Okay, so one trick that Jeremy taught in one of his classes, in one of his versions of fastai, is how to understand what happens inside the code, and that's what we're going to do. So what we can do is we can just take away this piece of code from inside a function and paste it outside. Okay, then what we do is we won't execute this entire function line by line, right? Because we may not understanding a complete function may be complicated, but we should be able to understand each line of the function. That should be pretty simple, right? Most of the times it's true. So what we'll do is we'll try to set some variables that are required for the function to run. Okay, and extensions has to be image extensions. Okay, recurse equal to true, folders equal to none. There's no problem with that. Follow links equal to true. Okay, so we have some variables initialized. Then we have path and path here. Okay, so what is path for us already? Path is actually a Python path, so we don't need to do anything. So what we'll do is let's get rid of this line. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to execute it one by one line at a time. Okay, and to do that in Jupyter Notebook or Lab, what you can do is you can say Control Shift minus, that is in Mac, there should be an equivalent key, both shortcut and Unix and Windows. Okay, so the next line is folders is equal to L of folders. We know folders is none. What is L? L is getting from a package called fastcore. It has got some amazing features. L is like a enhanced version of Python list. Okay, so let's see what happens here. So now we know that folders initially contain none in our case. So basically what it does is it creates an empty list. Okay, a normal Python list doesn't give you the number of elements in it. Here it also gets prof elements in it. There are other things that also can be done with a fast core list. Okay, to understand what is a fast core, let's also take a quick look at it. It's fastcore.fast.ai, and you can do a lot of things. One of my favorite thing is parallel. If you want to do parallel processing, I would highly recommend you to take a look at it. Okay, so let's get back to what we were doing. Then there is another line called certify extensions. Okay, what is certify? But as the name suggests, I would assume that if there are duplicates, it's going to remove it, right? Since it's already a set, I would assume that there would be no duplicates. And this is what is happening inside certify function. So this should work. Okay, then what we are doing is, if there are any capital case, we want to convert everything into lowercase. That's what is happening here. But then a lot of things are happening here. The one thing we can obviously do is we can remove the if, or just take these and do line by line. Okay, or just try to understand what is happening in each of these lines and probably take what we don't understand, right? If you're someone like me, okay, you may not understand what is happening here, os.walk, right? So let's take a look at it. So now we have path, we have follow links. Okay, I think this should give a generator. I don't want a generator because I'll not be able to understand what is happening. Okay, so it now know that we have a list. Okay, and it looks like there is a tuple and it has a directory, the path which we sent, and there is an empty list, and then there is a list of file names. Okay, so what we can do is we can probably say access the zeroth element and probably access the last element, which is a list of files, and then say just give me three files. Okay, fine. So now we know that this gives something like the directory path, whatever we passed in this case, directory names, which is empty here because there are no folders inside that folder structure. By the way, the path is something which we downloaded for the code, which is pets dataset. Okay, it's nothing fancy. And let's go back and see what happens, right? And the last return type is file names. It gives all the files that are inside the folder that we have given. Okay, we just printed the first three files. Okay, so now we know that what are we iterating over. Okay, now let's see what these few lines of code does. We're seeing a length of folders, we know which is empty, is not equal to zero. So that means we know that this line of code doesn't get executed. Else, okay, we are told that D, which is directory, which is basically any folders which are there, we are saying that equal to, we're iterating over that for O in D, which is again empty, so this doesn't happen. Okay, so I would assume that we get an empty list here. There is another if loop here, which says if length of folders is not equal to zero. We know that that's not the case. So basically what happens, my understanding is, all these three lines of code doesn't get executed. So what gets executed is the last line in the for loop. Okay, so what is basically happening is some value is getting added to the list. Okay, this is a Python list. Okay, what happens in get files? Okay, if you already know, you may have a surprise. Okay, it says object get files not found. That means it's not imported into the workspace. So let's do something a bit more complicated, but not really very much complicated. So what we will do is we'll go and search for fastai repository. Okay, so now once we are in the fastai repository, we can search for that function. It should be declared somewhere, right? It is declared in fastai data transforms.py. Okay, now let's do a command. Okay, it's here. So this is the function, right? So if you're probably using something like Visual Studio Code, you can just click on that and it takes you there. Okay, if you're using a Jupyter notebook, This would be an easy way to find where the function is written. So let's try to see what happens in this function. Okay, we have passed p. What is p here? The path that we pass to the function get files. F is one instance of the file. Extensions is the entire extensions that we have for images. So what happens here? We are iterating for f in fs. Okay, you're getting a list of files and we're taking the first element of that one file. If it does not start with a dot, what, why dot? Dots means basically there's some hidden file and we don't want it to be there in the images that we have. And it's not, if it's a dot, there's a very high chance it's not an image of a dog or something. It's probably some system file. We don't want it. Okay, we're taking the file. And then we just don't need the file. We need the entire path to the file, right? So the Python path lets you say slash do, okay, slash file. That's what we would have used it here, right? The way we say is, okay, you have a Python path that's getting returned here by entire data. We say slash images because we know that's where all the images are under, okay? So we came to the last line of this if. Okay, what if recurse is not true? Life becomes a lot simpler. Instead of saying os.walk, we say os.scan, okay? So what does os.scan directory does? We saw what does os.walk does. It returns directory path, basically what we sent, any folders inside it, any files in it, okay? What does this os.scan directory do? Okay, it returns a iterator of directory entry objects for a given path, okay? If you're like me, you may not understand what is happening, but let's look at this, what is happening. So I'm assuming that we get whatever is there inside that path, okay? And we check if is that it's a file. If it's a file, then just take the name of the file, okay? And that's in the if. So basically you'll get a list of all the files in that particular directory. Then what we do, we pass the files to get files. And what we know, what now we know, now we know that what get files does. It basically takes the path and appends each of the file to that, okay? It takes this particular thing, the name of the file, and I would assume that it says paths, okay? And let's put a quote around it. Otherwise, it would assume that it's a variable, right? This is what the underscore get file does. Whenever it say underscore, it's like a private thing in Python, so it's not shown here, okay? And then once you get, once you have completed the if and else part of this, we return to the last line where we convert the Python list to a fastai list, okay? And that's what we get, okay? So now we understood what get image files does. So let's call get image files, okay? And we know we have to pass the path, and let's say let's call, probably we know that it's going to return the files, right? Now we can see what should be the output. It should basically the each element, it should return all the files inside that particular directory, and each element should have the path slash the name of the file. You know that, right? Let's look at the first element of it, okay? So basically the idea is not just to understand what happens in get image files, but the idea is how to walk through each line and understand what happens in each line of the code, and thus understand a function. And probably you can always take a step back and try to see what happens in multiple functions. And that, I hope that helps you to understand more of it, right? I hope you like the video. If you like the video, please hit the like button. And if you have any comments, please share it with us. Thank you, folks. Bye-bye.